Good evening. I'm so glad that you could join us tonight as we celebrate the class of 2020. I'm Roy Getchell, and I'm the proud superintendent of the Haines Borough School District. But I hope you don't mind if I take off that hat for just a minute. Parents, I'm one of you tonight, so I'm going to put that on right now. I want us to go back to the year 2001 when all of you moms were getting ready to have our kids, and we're so thankful for the opportunities that we've had because of our children. We entered that period of time with September 11th, all wondering what kind of world it would be that we would be bringing our children into. We had no idea what was to come, but aren't we glad that our children are here and they're with us today? Sure, we've had some ups and downs. It's not always been easy, but could you imagine life without them? I can't. And with this class, we have a special, special group of young people. Interestingly, we bookend that experience with the COVID-19 response that we're all in right now. And not easy, it's something that will shape the lives of our graduates forever. My grandparents, our grandparents, members of the greatest generation, were great because of the experiences that they shared that shaped who they were, not because they were easy. So, with confidence, I am giving you an amazing class of 2020 with unique experience, just like the greatest generation, as we present them to our community, our country, and our world with confidence that they are going to make this all a better place. And now, without further ado, it's my great privilege and distinct honor to introduce tonight's speaker, the Honorable Senator Lisa Murkowski from the great state of Alaska.
Thank you. It is truly an honor to be with you at this graduation. You know, when you watch the video, when you see the students walking across a small bridge, or walking down the road, or through the woods, there still a little bit of snow on the ground. It's just a reminder that while this graduation is a celebration of these young people, it is a celebration of all those in the community who have worked to shape and build these young people that are moving, are transitioning from high school out into another level. And so while this is a graduation for the class of 2020, it is also a very significant, significant ceremony and commencement for the entire community. So my congratulations go out to all of you. You knew that the class of 2020 was going to be special. You know it when you just think about we're the class of 2020. We're special. We are a new decade. But it probably is an understatement to say nobody really had any idea that it was going to be, that this class and your commencement was going to be as different as it is. And it's not just the graduating class of Haines High School, it is all the graduating classes of 2020. So I had an opportunity to receive an email message. Let's see, it was the 21st of April from your class president, Dylan Chappell. And Dylan, in a pretty simple email, says, "Hey, I'd like to invite you to come and speak at the Haines High School graduation on May 19th, maybe by Zoom or something like that." Now that is a pretty untraditional invitation to come and speak at your graduation, but it got me, and I am again honored to be with you tonight as we celebrate virtually. I am back here in Washington, D.C. You are in Haines. You probably have family members that are scattered not only all over the state, but all over the United States, who are able to watch you as you graduate this afternoon. But when you think about the ways in which you as students have come together to make this commencement special, that your community has come together to make this commencement special, and that others have as well, I do hope that it does make you feel special, because you truly are. When you think about the ways in which our world has truly been turned upside down in simply the past couple months, for many it was a recognition that after spring break, there was no returning to school. There was no socialization with friends. There was no sports. There was no prom. There was no life as you as students knew it. And that is disruptive, to say the least. It's disruptive from a social perspective, but it is disruptive from an academic perspective. And yet here you are, graduating, and graduating with pride and pride from your community. As I speak to students across the state about this very significant time in their life, I try to remind them that so much of who they are is a reflection of the community that they are from. And while I may not know most of you that are graduating, I have met some, but I do not know most of you. What I do know about Haines, I think, is reflective of you. And as I was thinking earlier about the people in Haines and who you are, you're fishermen, you're miners, you harvest timber, you are very, very engaged in advocates for tourism for your region. You're skiers. You are conservationists. You care for the eagles at the conservatory. You brew pretty good beer. You are an artistic community. There is a sense of history and pride in what you have at Fort Seward. You're a transit point, have been since World War II. You have strong climate advocates, both young and old. You have a great love for your country in hosting so many of our honored veterans. You care for our seniors in your senior facility. You have an award-winning library. You're state champions in sports. You have community advocates in mental health. And I think about that as a community, and how well-rounded as a community Haines is. And I can't help but think how well-rounded you as graduating students from Haines High School are as you reflect your community. And you need to be, because this is a time for resilience. This is a time for flexibility. This is a time for adaptability. And I hope that as you have gone through these past several months where your life has been disrupted in a way that really doesn't make sense, I hope you recognize that in many ways what you have been through has been a challenge. You have been tried. And you have been tested. You have been forced to do things that, again, disturb your social world. Your life has literally been defined by social distancing. You're facing a level of uncertainty with a job market that is turned upside down, the unknown of what college life will look like in the fall. And these can be daunting challenges. But my challenge to you is not to be daunted, not to be overwhelmed, but to embrace this as a challenge. And as I've shared with others, if there's any takeaway, if there's any motto, if there's any theme for the graduating class of 2020, allow it to be expect the unexpected. Because life will deliver you challenges and force you into detours and push you to do things that were not part of your plan. And how you choose to deal with that will really help to shape and define the direction that you will go. So use your talents and the flexibility and the adaptability that you have. I would venture to say that many of you are so prepared to enter this new world where there is change afoot on so many different levels. But the technology, the ease within which you can come and go in a manner and a way that allows you to be the leader, I hope you embrace that. If I could have just shared with you the 5 minutes before this ceremony began, and my frustration in trying to access Zoom and understand how I was gonna find the right password. And I'm more than certain that if I had any one of you sitting with me, we would have been able to get right into it right then. But this is my point to you. The skill sets that you have, the knowledge that you have learned, the confidence and the ease with which you can move forward, allow this to work to your benefit. You have come so far. Your community is proud of you. Your family, your friends are proud of you. And Alaskans are proud of you. So as you move forward, as you take on this next step, whether it is entering the job market, furthering your academic education, contributing to your state and to your community, know that what you have received as a student at Haines High School, what you have received will carry you forward in ways that will be enduring, that will allow you to be resilient, and will allow you to embrace whatever challenges come before you. So know that I stand with the community of Alaskans in wishing you well on your next adventure. We're very, very, very proud of you, and we wish you well. Congratulations to all of you. Congratulations to the families that have supported you, and to the teachers, the superintendents, the principals, all those who have helped you this far on your journey. God bless you all, and take care. Be well.
Thank you so much, Senator Murkowski. We so appreciate your words of wisdom, and we appreciate your service to the state of Alaska and your advocacy for education. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hi, everyone. I'm Principal Rene Martin, and I have the great pleasure of talking a little bit about some honor awards for our students. And as we watch the graduates pick up their diplomas and in their entry video, you may have noticed some other bling on some of the graduates. So the yellow cords that are on many of the graduates represent membership in the National Honor Society. They represent the four pillars of the National Honor Society: leadership, scholarship, service, and character. This year's seniors are Dylan Chapel, Dory Getchell, and Joseph Rossman. Great job. Next, you may have seen students with the stole, with the yellow stole around their necks that said honors. And that's for achieving a 3.7 or higher GPA cumulative for their entire high school career. Those students are Aurora Alten-Huber, Dylan Chapel, Marirose Evenden, and Melanie Thomas. And finally, you'll see two students with medals. First is our salutatorian, Aurora Alten-Huber, and our valedictorian, Marirose Evenden. We're very proud of you. The staff congratulates you. We know it takes a lot of hard work to get to that point. Finally, I'd like to award the Eric McDowell Award. Eric was a 1959 Haines High School alumnus and a Juneau community activist throughout his entire life. This award is given to a male and female student who exemplifies a well-rounded high school career by participating in a variety of activities and sports, and it's chosen by the staff. A little drum roll, please. This year's recipients of the Eric McDowell Award are Megan Whittermore and Kirby Faverty. Congratulations, you two. That's a big honor. All right, it's time to transition to our next step, and it is with great pleasure that I introduce your valedictorian, Marirose Evenden.
Hi, everyone. I could give you life advice, but let's be honest, I'm not in a position to do that. We've all been around for about the same amount of time. So what is the point of my speech? I spent a lot of time thinking about that, and I came up with three things I want to say to my fellow classmates. Congratulations, thank you, and goodbye. To say congratulations because we have accomplished something. We have finished a chapter of our lives. We have worked hard and pushed each other over the last 13 years to get to this point. So congratulations, let's celebrate this. I want to say thank you for pushing me and all of us. Through competition and teamwork, we've brought each other to this moment of our lives. Thank you for bringing up real-world questions in English discussions, for doing the research and debating whether earthquakes or volcanoes are more destructive, for sharing ideas while building Rube Goldberg machines, for being the class that even when split, came together to win the Earth Day cleanup in fifth grade. A trip to Skagway to gold pan and play with puppies sure was worth it. Looking back, it is clear that together we have accomplished something great. We have helped each other become contributing members of a community we are all lucky to call home. Graduation is our chance to celebrate this accomplishment, reflect on our years together, and say goodbye. Say goodbye to the routine, to the building, to the people who have been there for us for all these years, and most importantly, to each other. Right now, we don't know when or if we will ever be together again. Now, we all set out to accomplish the incredible things I know from firsthand experience we're all capable of. Here is to an amazing 13 years together and to an open and exciting future we all have in front of us. Haines High School, class of 2020, congratulations, thank you, and until next time. Please be patient as my classmates and I transition to awarding of diplomas, which will be streamed at 6:30 on the school's YouTube page. Thank you.
In the quiet, misty morning, when the moon has gone to bed, when the sparrows stop their singing, and the sky is clear and red,
when the summer ceased its gleaming, when the corn is past its prime, set me free to find my call.
Madam President of the Haines-Borough School District, having completed all of the requirements for graduation, I am proud to present to you the class of 2020. Aurora Alten-Huber. Brant Alten-Huber. Dylan River Galligan Chapel. Cade A. Clay. Carver Campbell Culbeck. Cyrus Don Davis Hamilton. Tana Rose Dixon. Marirose Evenden. Kirby Lee Faverty. Kaylee Brianne Fisher. Hannah Doreen Getchell. Nathaniel Leroy Haas. Odin James Jacobson. Levi M. McClurg. Joseph Scott Rossman. Gable Allen Sage. Dominic S. A. Stossel. Kyle J. Strong Alex. Melanie Thomas. Rebecca Dawn Wheeler. Megan Lynn Whittemore. Rain Haley Wing.